Hi, my name is Ruben Voluntad. I'm an applications technician for the Simple Switcher product line here at Texas Instruments. Today, I want to show you how to simplify power regulator prototyping through the manufacturing process. In today's market, parts are offered in many different packages. Two classifications are leadless and leaded packages. Today, I want to show you how leaded packages will be more advantageous in your prototyping. Two examples I want to bring up are the WSON, a wide, small outline, no leaded package, and the SOIC, a small outline integrated circuit. Now, as you can see here, with the WSON, although it's smaller and offers you a smaller condensed layout, it's really hard to work with because you can't see the leads. And after a rework, you might need a specialized piece of equipment like an X-ray to see if you soldered it on well. Unlike with the SOIC, you can see the leads and it offers you a wider pitch and the possible of solder bridges is really rare. As you can see, this not only simplifies the manufacturing process, it also reduces manufacturing costs. When you have to procure expensive equipment, X-ray inspection typically adds to variable costs in manufacturing. So right now, let me show you how I remount and demount an SOIC part. For today's demonstration, I'll be using the LMR23630 EVM board, which has a SOIC on it. But before that, let me show you what I have to work with. I have a preheater, vise, hot air reflow system, a liquid dispenser that dispenses the liquid solder, and some soldering irons just for any cleanup. Some of my small tools are tweezers, solder braid to clean up the landing area, and some isopropanol alcohol and cotton swabs to clean up any residue. And of course, safety glasses for safety. Let's begin. First, let me turn on the preheater and this hot air reflow system. I'll move the board over to the preheater. The preheater is used to preheat the board just in case if your SOIC has a bottom DAP. I'll move the nozzle down as closest to the part as I can. Try to center it. At this point, it usually takes about a minute to a minute and a half for the solder to melt and have the part be removed. So after that time has elapsed, I'll take my tweezers. So as you see, the solder has liquefied, I can take it off. And there you have it. I have successfully demounted an SOIC. Now it is ready to be remounted with a new part. But first, I'm gonna clean up the landing area. With that, I'll be using the solder braid and my soldering irons. I'll take the solder braid and the soldering iron. Okay. Upon general inspection of the board, as you can see here, it is all cleaned up. Now I'll solder the liquid solder on the landing area. So here I have the new part. So before I put that on, I'm gonna take the liquid solder and put it on all the exposed metal on the part. First, I'll put it on the DAP, then on the leads. This is one of the advantages of having an SOIC. With the wider pitch, I can put all this liquid solder on the landing area and I won't have to fear any solder bridges happening. At this point, don't worry about the liquid solder overflowing all over the place. The EVM board has a solder mask protectant so that it's not gonna go to any other lead for it to short. So now that I have the part on there, I'm gonna put it back on the hot air reflow station so that I can solder it. Just like before, I put it as close to the part as I can. And within the same time frame, about a minute to a minute and a half, you will see the solder paste liquefy and turn into a more shinier and metal state. After some time has passed, most of the solder is already liquefied and solid. Upon further inspection, I don't need to do any cleanup after that. As you can see, these are the advantages of having a SOIC part during prototyping. With its wider pitch and exposed leads, the manufacturing process is made simple. Well, that's it for this demonstration. Thank you very much.